Hi, welcome to Crow's BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going over the four steps to creating incredible Power BI scatter charts. Before we jump into any of that, make sure you go down, hit like, subscribe, turn on that little bell icon to get alerted every time we publish new content. All right, let's head over to it. The first thing I always want to do is I want to make sure that I have my grounding KPIs. These are going to be the key KPIs that your users are going to know. They're going to want to know that what's relevant towards, you know, the report that I'm looking for. These are going to be the high level metrics that will help your users and the people who are consuming your reports understand what it is that they're looking at, right? The second thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you have enough room for that scatter chart, right? Like I said, you want to take up as much room as you possibly can for that while allowing for there to be some other space on your canvas to give your users some additional navigation tips, all right? So that's where we're going to start to get into having some visual slicers. Now, these slicers are going to be done a little bit differently. That's going to be in step three. Can't wait to show you the visual slicers and then also those more detailed slicers, okay? So once you lay this out, start by creating this space. Go into PowerPoint. I've done a number of different videos on showing you that. There's some samples out on Kratos BI, the seed files, that can help you get started with that. But making sure that you have a nice layout here really helps when it comes time to getting your making sure that this is consumable by your users, okay? All right, step two when creating a great scatter chart is to really focus in on how you want the scatter chart to look, feel, and function for your end users. Remember, the scatter chart is all about showing details and highlighting outliers inside of the data set. You know, so finding those people that are doing exceptionally good in one, two, or three different dimensions. And we'll talk about that in just a second. When we talk about details, we're talking about who are the individuals that you're going to be analyzing. These can be customers, these can be products, these can be salespeople. It's whatever detailed aspects you want to be reviewing. Scatter charts have been called the most powerful visual analytics ever created. People can be afraid of them because they get into a lot of detail. You see a lot on your screen. That's why it's important to include to do this stuff right. Your predominant measures are going to be your X and your Y. So your X is your run, your Y is your height. I like to focus in on dollar amount going up, whereas your y-axis can be any of your other measures. The third measure that you want to include inside your visual is that size, right? So your size you want to be to allow to differentiate from, you know, you may have a client that's extremely profitable, but maybe the total sales is lower. Or you could see that they're, you know, you've got a ton of sales to a customer and, you know, there's been many of them, but maybe the profit margin is razor thin. That, you know, having that size be a profit margin can really help a user understand, like, okay, this is a good big client. I want to, you know and understand them. But, you know, I've got one guy who's over here who's very small with a profit margin, and I've got another guy in a different space that is we have a much better profit margin with. And then the next big thing that I like to do inside a scatter chart is make sure that the tooltips you have on your scatter chart are actionable and that people can, that your users will be able to do something with that information. If you're gonna go to that extent to build out a scatter chart, you wanna go in and create an action tooltip. I'm gonna show you that stuff right now. Okay, so here's my dashboard. Here's my scatter chart. I've got my resellers. I've got broken out there. I add in a business type to break this out to give a little more visual cues as to the type of industry that I'm dealing with. Like I said, I have my quantity on my x-axis and I have my reseller sales amount on my y-axis. And then I've got my unit price on my size, okay? Now for the action tooltip, like I said, I wanted this to pop out and show me something more. So in this case, I captured all the key KPI metrics, grounding metrics that I had, and then I included all of the information that would allow my users to do something with this, right? So I could see the name, I could see the phone number, I could see the address, and then I've also included a narrative from Narrative Sciences that give me more depth and information about what's been going on historically for a client. Okay, so step three in creating a very useful and great scatter chart is to give the user some visual cues on how to slice and dice the information that they're looking for. Now, you could go and just put a bunch of slicers on your chart, but that we want to do something more than that. We want to, you know, slicers work if the users know exactly who they want to look at and how they want to filter down to that. We want to help our users by giving them visual cues on the different segments or areas that they may want to go in and look at. All right, so let's go take a look at how you can do that. So basically, if you remember the layout, we had an area on the bottom for our visual slicers and the detailed slicers. So I want to create some visuals that I'm going to populate in here, and then I want to create a visual that I want to include on my detailed slicer. While I'm not a super fan of the ring charts, these can be very effective inside of this tooling to give your users the ability to visually see which segments they want to look at. Now, it's very important if you're doing this type of thing to try to keep the number of units under 5. If you're going to be doing breakouts, it can be very hard for users to differentiate the differences. As a rule of thumb, 5 is the most you really want to do. We basically lay these out. Now, I'm just doing 4 to keep this simple, right? I want it to be usable by users. So I'm finding the 4 biggest dimensions that I want users to look at. And then I have a more detailed dimension that allows the users to understand and filter by more specific geographical regions that they may want to look at. All right, and then the final part is how do we bring this all together and to create an incredible experience for our users? Now, by taking our layout, by keeping our big grounded KPIs up on top, by giving our scatter chart plenty of room, exist on the page, and then by laying out all of my visuals along the bottom, making sure that I've aligned them and I've equally distributed them, I create a portal that allows users to go in and more accurate, you know, dig into and understand what's going on inside their data. The big thing that we want to do here is when we select a visual, we want to go up to our format and we want to edit our interactions. The big key is changing all of these visuals to slice instead of highlight, right? So we don't want to just highlight inside of the scatter chart. We want to be slicing down. This creates this makes each of these visuals of a slicer. So it's very easy for me to select Europe, sales from 2012, and then quickly go in and find the handful of customers that I have who haven't made a sale in the last year, who may be large that I may want to do something with. So the 10th bike store here, maybe someone that I want to call out to find out, you know, what happened, why aren't they buying any more bikes. By creating these slicers and controlling this interaction, it allows users to go from a very cluttered scatter chart that can have way too many details into quickly honing in and finding a group of customers that may be very useful and may help really drive sales. All right, thank you for joining me today. I hope you learned the 4 steps to creating a great scatter chart report. This is one of the more incredible visuals that's out there, especially when you're trying to understand details and who your outliers are to help drive your organizational success. If you like the content that we're doing, please hit like, subscribe to the channel, even turn on that little alarm bell that helps the channel growth and adoption. Really appreciate that stuff. If you really like what we got going on here, head over to KratosBI.com, buy me a coffee. I got the I Love Power BI, you know, magnets that are out there. I got the magic hologram stickers and hot off the press. I got the brand new I Love Power BI magnets with the brand new logo that's associated in there. So head over there, buy me a coffee. I'll send these out as a thank you for you. It's helped support the channel and helps grow everything we do. Thank you guys very much. I really appreciate everything. Peace.